skeletal system, it is of two types. Number one, axial skeleton. Number two, appendicular skeleton. What is axial skeleton? The bones present in the central axis, that is the midline, central axis of the body constitutes axial skeleton. Example, skull, vertebra or vertebral column, that is there are 33 vertebrae, okay, sternum, ribs, and hyoid bone. The skull, the skeleton of the head is known as skull. It has two, okay, cranium. The skull without the mandible is called cranium. The cranium is divided into viscerocranium and neurocranium. The bones forming the face constitutes viscerocranium, whereas the bones which covers and protects the brain forms the neurocranium. Number two, vertebra or the vertebral column. There are 33 vertebrae. 33 vertebrae. The cervical vertebrae. Cervical means neck. The cervical vertebrae. There are 7 cervical vertebrae. Thoracic. There are 12 thoracic vertebrae. Lumbar. There are 5 lumbar vertebrae. Okay. And sacrum. It consists of a single fused structure made up of 5 sacrum bones. Okay. And the coxis is like a small piece attached to the base of the sacrum, which is made up of 4 pieces. So totally there are 33 vertebrae. Okay. Sternum and the ribs. Okay. The ribs, there are 12 pairs of ribs attached to the sternum by a cartilage known as costal cartilage. According to the attachments, the ribs are divided into true ribs, false ribs, and floating ribs. What are true ribs? The ribs which are directly attached to the sternum, directly attached to the sternum through the costal cartilage, are known as true ribs. So, example, 1 to 7 ribs are true ribs. The first to 7th ribs are true ribs. False ribs, the ribs which are indirectly attached to the sternum, that is, these ribs are attached to the costal cartilage of the 7th rib, okay, which is attached to the sternum. So, they are indirectly attached to the sternum. For example, 8th, 9th and 10th ribs are false ribs. Okay. And the last one is floating ribs. What are floating ribs? They are not attached to the sternum. Okay. So, 11th and 12th ribs are floating ribs. Bones of upper limb. Okay. Number 1, clavicle. Number 2, scapula. Humerus, bone of the arm. Radius and ulna, bone of the forearm. Carpal bones, there are 8 carpal bones. Scaphoid, lunate, triquetral, fusiform in the upper row or superior row. Distal row contains trapezium, trapezoid, capitate and hamate. So totally 8 bones and 5 metacarpal bones. 5 metacarpal bones. And the phalanges, okay, there are 3 phalanges in each finger except for the thumb, it contains only 2. Okay, so totally 14 phalanges. So these are the bones of upper limb. The bones of the lower limb, okay, the bones of the lower limb are innominate bone or the hip bone. It consists of 3 parts, ilium, ischium and pubis. So totally 3 bones joins together form a single piece, that is the innominate bone. Femur, that is a thigh bone, longest bone in the body. Femur, okay, and the leg, you have tibia and fibula. Tibia and fibula. And then, like carpal, you have tarsal bones in the foot. Tarsal bones, there are 7 tarsal bones. Calcaneum, that is the heel bone. Talus, navicular. Cuneiform, there are 3 cuneiforms, medial cuneiform, intermediate cuneiform and lateral cuneiform. And one more bone, cuboid, there is a bone. So these are the tarsal bones. There are 5 metatarsal bones and 14 phalanges. Sesamoid bone. What is sesamoid bone? It is a bone which is enclosed or covered by tendon or a ligament. Is known as sesamoid bone. Example, patella is the largest sesamoid bone, and you have fusiform bone in the carpal. It is an example for sesamoid bone. There are so many places you have sesamoid bones. Fabula is a sesamoid bone present in the gastrocnemius or the cough muscle present there in the leg. So these are some of the bones of upper and lower limb. Okay, we will see each and every bone in detail during osteology class.